Phil Valentine. It's just common sense.
Well, we got a couple of guests. One of these gentlemen I don't know very well. I have had lunch with him. The other one I go back 20 years or more with. Jonathan Bradford is an artist. I mean, a musical artist. But he's also got a project out with Bill Cuomo. Now, Bill Cuomo is somebody that I've known for a long time. And matter of fact, you probably know him and don't know it. Johnny's going to play you. These are just a sampling of some intros that Bill Cuomo was responsible for. See if you recognize any of these tunes. Sounds familiar. Oh, yeah. Yeah. I think I heard that one, man. Played it about 300,000 times on the radio.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know.
He was known as the intro king in LA for many years back in the 80s. Bill Cuomo was here with us as well as Jonathan. Right, gentlemen, how are you?
Fine. We're good. Fine. Glad to be here.
The reason you're here is not because you did Betty Davis Eyes or because you did all these other wonderful songs. It's because you got a new project out. And I don't know whether you saw my posting on Facebook today, because I'm calling it a novestool. It's a nova that's a musical.
Ah. Wow, that's clever.
Or a novical, I think is what I call
the
it.
The ironic part being the two guys that don't really like musicals write a musical.
It's amazing. Yeah. But when you told me about this, is around Christmas, you told me we were doing this, and you sent me a little sampling of it. I said, this is brilliant stuff.
Oh, cool. Thank you. It's uncharted territory for us.
It is.
It's different.
So this is really a novel that is, it's got music in between.
Yes. Yeah, it has a lot of underscoring, but then we break for songs that are not radio record length, but they're, you know, maybe a minute and a half, couple minutes, in between the dialogue. So there's a break, and if there's a particular scene that warrants it, that's where it went.
And it brings all of this together, brings the story together, doesn't it?
Yeah.
So did you bring this to Bill, Jonathan?
That is correct. Okay. I was writing it just to amuse myself. I wanted to basically see if I could make a long song.
Mm-hmm.
Can I make this thing rhyme? How long can I make this thing rhyme?
Right.
And then, you know, I got it all finished, and I said, you know, there's only two people I know that wouldn't throw me out. And one is Bill Cuomo, because he's always on the forefront of unconventional.
Right.
So if he would buy it, I knew it was gold. And so I took it to him, and he was like, I'm going to sign on to this thing. Let's do it. And,
wow.
And that's how it started.
How long ago was that?
2 years.
Really?
A little over 2 years ago. Yeah, because he brought me, I joke about it now, he brought me a book. And it was all short rhyme, written like a song lyric. And I said, well, if we're going to do this, let's stretch the lyric out so the rhymes aren't quite so obvious.
Right.
And so we started doing that and rewriting that thing. And then we went back and rewrote again. And then we had to make sure, I mean, you're a novelist, so you know this.
Mm-hmm.
You have to be careful there's no hanging unanswered questions or everything is consistent. So we'd go over and over. And that took the bulk.
Yeah,
the music
that's
a breeze.
Tough. Yeah, you guys do me. Well, tell us about your background, Jonathan, in music, because you got a new CD out too called The Forgotten Ones.
Yeah, The Forgotten Ones is actually on the charts right now on Airplay Radio. It's at 22 on the charts.
Oh, good, excellent.
It's real music. You know, it's stuff that, you know, harkens back to like Sting, Peter Gabriel, Phil Collins, a little bit Maroon 5, but it's more nostalgic. And so I met Bill, 8 years ago?
Yeah.
Because he really enjoyed what I was about. I was always about the art. I think being a student of music, you always have to put yourself in a position of not knowing how to get out of the corner.
Right.
You know, I like to challenge myself in that way. And so that's why him and I have that chemistry.
We started writing. As a matter of fact, we dug up a couple things and listened to how we got started, you know, and how the songs were. And I went back and listened to a couple of them, and I went, wow, these are really good. We should do something with them. And one of them we had that had drums and everything on it, we loved the lyric, but it wasn't right for the story. So we went back, and I scored it with strings, and I just lifted Jonathan's vocals, as you know, you can do with a computer, and we just slid them into this new background, and it worked out great.
And sure this did. Is called, by the way, The Shipwreck Souls is the name of the book.
Yeah, and we have a website, of course. You know.
A Pirate Tale.
Yeah.
So is this on Audible and places like this?
It's everywhere. We worked really hard. We've got it. We were distributed through Google.
Mm-hmm.
So we've got on every Audible book, audiobook retailer. And that took a while, as you know, because you're on on Audible.
They got to approve it and all that
stuff.
And it takes a while.
The hard part for us was we have a written one. We had to go through Kindle first because Amazon won't take it if you don't have a print version. Right. So you have to have the ebook. But the ebook really, it's a musical, so it doesn't work like it does as an Audible.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so.
But you had to do that to get
it. Had to do it, you know. So I had to get the Kindle program and then write the whole thing out to make sure there weren't any weird words or paragraphs or things, you know, so everything looked neat. That was a process. That took me about 5 days.
That's fun.
Isn't it? It's fun, huh?
Well, let me play. And I guess the Seafaring Men, that's you. Right,
that's Johnny? Correct, yeah.
Okay, Johnny, if you can grab the Seafaring Men cut, that's on the one that were those other three cuts were that we just played Bill's intros. And this is just to see. So you're going along, and we'll let you hear some of the narration too, because this Aussie guy's fantastic.
Isn't David, isn't he?
But fantastic. This is Jonathan and part of the musical interlude of this. Takes a second to get going. Yeah.
And silence creeps in, left all alone, all alone. The seafaring men living the life once again. The seafaring men in what they defend.
Now, on the other email I sent you, Johnny, grab the narrator, because this guy, so you got to imagine that this is going along as an audiobook, and this guy, who sounds like a seafaring man.
He is. He's Crocodile Dundee of the ocean.
Yeah, Indiana Jones.
He's sailed around the world, this guy has, literally.
Yeah, surfed a tsunami in a boat.
And this guy's, what's his name, David?
Yep, David Fiddler.
David Fiddler. Here's how this goes.
He realized his plan to escape had vanished with his ship, along with the love of his life that wanted freedom from his chauvinistic grip. Suddenly he heard, "And wherein you might think you be going, lad? For this port has eyes all about, and me bucko, it be ironclad." Captain Peck realized within a moment of that stare that Edward knew that he was indeed trifling in his affairs. "Blimey, ye best know, Culver, that nothing gets by me, boy, cause I slain a many a man like you, even at their employ. You dare to lie to me face? Then to the gallows let it be. But that not be you today, as I have better plans for thee."
And so to the clink he went, as he was drug off in plain view, all the while being tormented as to what was in store for himself and his crew.
"I am Blackbeard, don't ever lie to me, cause in me kingdom all me eyes can see I be a fair man. Honest to me would, but if you cross me, your voice no longer be heard."
See, I just thought this whole idea was just fantastic, because here you got a narrator that's got great pipes to start with, but he's also telling the story of the shipwrecked souls.
Yeah.
And then the music comes in, like a musical, and then it goes back to the story, and it's just great way to tell.
It's just woven in and out. You know?
Oh, yeah, because most people are listening to audiobooks, including mine, and then after a while you're going, "Oh, okay, where was I? I think I fell asleep there." So this keeps you going, keeps you engaged. Between narration and the music.
You'll have to go to our website, Phil, when you have a minute, which I, you know, if you're going to have a minute, you're a busy guy. But we did a teaser. We did four teasers.
Right.
And the fourth teaser was a sarcastic ploy at audiobooks.
Right. I saw that.
Yeah. Okay. You know, where we were just going, you know, they not only do they just have narration with nothing else, but then they remove all the breathing.
Right.
And everything. So it sounds like you're being narrated to by a robot.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going, man, this has got to be better, because I'm a huge audiobook fan.
Yeah.
When Vanessa and I take drives, we're, you know, glued to the audiobooks. And, boy, now that they're unabridged, 12 hours of just that.
Yeah, it's a lot.
Yeah, it's a good sleeper, you know.
Well, but this, I mean, you got the, you not only that, but you put sound effects under everything, too. That had to have taken forever.
Oh, yeah, and then.
It did.
You know, and we think a lot alike. I have two psychology graduates that are crazy, you know. And so we'd listen to stuff. And I'd say something, and he'd be saying the same thing. You know, we got to go back. That door slam doesn't sound right.
Right.
Or the fall down the stairs doesn't sound lifelike, or whatever it was. When you played Seafaring Men, that was the first song. that we put in the dialogue in chapter one. That was the first one, and we went, you know, this is going to work. Yeah. So then we started thinking about where the next one's going to go and who's going to sing him. Well, Jonathan being a great vocalist, it was great, but we needed a female vocalist.
We're going to play her in just a second. Yeah. And I want you to tell me about her.
Yeah, Mo Loughran runs a Nashville Creative House, and she, back before she was a mom, she had a band, and you remember the American Music Awards?
Mm-hmm.
She won them.
Oh, really?
I think around 2004, she won Best Alternative Act.
Wow.
So, I mean, she can sing.
Well, we're going to play that for you in just a second. We'll take a quick time out. We'll be back in a moment. We're talking with Bill Cuomo and Jonathan Bradford. It's called Shipwreck Souls.
The
Shipwreck Souls. And you can find it audiobook, Audible, Amazon.
Kobo.
Wherever you find yeah. books and musicals.
Yeah.
615-737-9986. We're back with more right after this. So we're in studio with Bill Cuomo and Jonathan Bradford, and the Shipwreck Souls is their project. It's just think of it as it's an audio book with music, I guess.
Yeah, that's a fair assessment.
A novical, I believe is what I call it.
Yes.
So I think I've coined a term. So I'm looking at Bill Cuomo's All Access or All Music page. I mean, you've worked with Whitesnake, of course. We heard, you know, talking about that. I mean, everybody. Rick Springfield, Seals and Croft, Kim Carnes, of course, as we heard then. You worked with Little River Band, Tanya Tucker, Janice Ian, Natalie Cole, Engelbert Humperdinck, James Taylor. You've been on his records. Is anybody you have, Dolly Parton, anybody you haven't been on a record? Trace Atkins. You've been on Trace Atkins.
Right? I played on his first record. You know, because I came to town here. All my friends were moving here.
Mm-hmm.
Came here in 89. And so I started doing country records till about, I think, about the mid-90s. And then I fired myself.
Yeah. Not going to do country records.
I didn't think I was doing it justice.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Because you're not a big country music fan.
No, and you can't fake art.
Yeah.
You know, it's tough. It's really tough. I still, you know, that era of 70s and 80s is, you know, in the brain, and that's where I go naturally.
And yeah, the old Sherry thing, which you were a co-writer on that.
Yeah.
And did the intro, and which has become so distinctive.
You know, Jonathan and I were talking about Unconventional, and that was the tie-in with him in the sense that the records that I had my success with were apart from the normal.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody ever did a tune where they started the intro, they had the song, and then the suite closed the song like an O'Sherry.
Right.
Betty Davis Eyes was tracked with a synthesizer, which in 1981 was not done.
I remember when that thing came out. It was so innovative.
Yeah, and then there was no solo.
Mm-hmm.
There was just the riff. And right. the ch-ch-ch. And the record execs are screaming, pulling out their hair, going, got to put a guitar solo in there.
Man, we ain't got one.
No, yeah. Yeah, we got a solo already. Go away. And then Kim Carnes, I did a record with her. Her first big hit for Smokey Robinson's song. And that was...
Being With You?
More Love.
More Love, okay.
More Love, right. And we had the song all in the can. The producer comes up and says, hey, give me a classical intro. And I said, well, we have an intro. He goes, no, I want an intro in front of the intro. So I did this, you know, the song's already cut. I did this 30-second classical thing off the top of my head. And I thought, oh, no, we're doomed now.
Dun, 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 dun. I remember that.
Yeah, and the disc jockeys loved it.
I loved it.
They would talk right up until the drum fill.
Oh, yeah. It made you feel so erudite.
Well, that's it. You know, they had the classical chamber behind them while they talk and announce the artist.
Well, tell me about that, because we only got about a minute and a half left. This woman we're going to play, Fade Away, she's the vocalist on
Mo,
this.
Yeah.
Let's play that, Johnny, and then you'll tell us who this woman is, because she's fantastic.
Yeah.
Time cannot be promised, it can only be taken away. I thought that love was black and white, but now it's shades of gray. My light, my love, my heart, my soul, I could never ask for more. You're the one I really adore. Why am I the one who's all alone? I can see you, I can feel you. If only you could find a way to stay. I still need you,
Who is this woman?
Who is this woman? I know, isn't she great? Mo Loughran.
Okay.
Hi, Mo.
Hi, Mo.
She's listening right now.
Yeah, I hope she is. But she's an amazing
a dream
singer. Yeah.
She's a dream.
Well, this and this is out everywhere. Shipwreck Souls.
Yes, sir. Yeah. Everywhere. It's at theshipwrecksouls.com. You can go there. You can buy it there. You can subscribe to our podcasts. We're following Uncle Phil.
There you go.
I was impressed.
Yeah, thank you.
I thought Cameron was you.
Yes,
I want you to,
so did I.
I was amazed at how much he sounds like
Cameron
you.
And I sound like
you do.
I said we sound just alike.
Yeah, yeah.
And he's just a new and improved me.
Oh.
Bill Cuomo and Jonathan Bradford. It's the Shipwreck Souls. You can find it at theshipwrecksouls.com. Thanks, guys.
Thank you,
Thank
Phil.
Thank you so
Thanks
much,
for
Phil.
Having us in.
Appreciate it.